we can see the Opel Adam on the start line, ready to take on the first stage.
Yeah, so Lukas Mateja, Juuna Pankkinen, who was the 2018 winner of the Dirt 4 Championship, John Harris, Maxime Wagner, Sam Thornton, Matthias Adielsen, who is Katie's teammate. Let's get ready to go racing then. This is Group A in the Steam category, and we are away. So the order, the live order, will be to the top right of your screen, and you'll be able to see who is where along the stage to the left of your screen. They're all set off at the same time. So this first part of the stage, there is going to be lots of changing of position, but it looks like Juuna Pankkinen has got himself into the lead, battling away with Maxime Wagner, the Dutch driver, Juuna Pankkinen, the Finnish driver, and he is in the lead at the moment, and that is who we are following on screen. So Juuna Pankkinen, we can see this, the tarmac section, Katie, of the stage. So this a chance for them to someone to try and gain a lead so that they can be a little bit more cautious when we get to the ice.
Yeah, I'd say this is probably, from a driver's perspective, this is the easiest section of the stage. You know, this is abrasive tarmac, it's quite predictable. There's some patches of ice, but really, you've got good grip here. They are going to be on studded tyres, so it's a little bit like driving on gravel. You know, you can see the car sliding around the corners. They're not completely gripping, they are, you know, you can see them coming in sideways there. As we progress into the stage, we're going to get icier conditions. You'll see those studs really starting to work, but really great driving. He's using all of the road here. We're with Matthias Adielsen, so he's in fifth place at the minute, but you can see really using that racing line. It'll be interesting to see when we get into the icy sections if they kind of keep it a little bit more straight, you know, because the racing line isn't always best in Monte Carlo. There's ice patches, there's snow patches. Really, your job is just to avoid those if you can.
And you're familiar with these cars. These are the class of car that you actually racing at the European Rally Championship. So tell us a little bit about how these cars are going to be handling, particularly when we get to the ice. What's the trick to getting used to them?
They're little pocket rockets, really. You know, they're front-wheel drive rally cars. That means they're only driven by the front wheel. So, you know, if they're getting understeer, which I'm sure we're going to see a little bit later, on some of the icy sections, you haven't got the power coming through those rear wheels to help rotate it like you would have it with a rear-wheel drive or a four-wheel drive car. Obviously, later on into the semi-finals tonight, we'll be moving up to the four-wheel drive cars, so you'll be able to see that different driving style. But I think that one of the most difficult things about this rally Monte Carlo, is with the R2, you really use the weight transfer to rotate the car. So it's the late braking into the apex, and it's almost the weight transfer that really brings it round into a slide. Here, it's difficult to do that. It's so icy, you know, if you're leaving the braking to the last minute, it's very easy to just completely understeer and completely overcook the corner. So we can see Matthias has dropped down. Oh, he's back up. Oh, it's so tight. They're moving around all over the place. In fifth place at the minute.
You can see it's dark as well, isn't it? So vision is not going to be as great as you would have within the day. You can see there are the ice patches, and sometimes you don't know exactly when they're going to be arriving. This is a 7-minute stage, so it's very long stage, hard to remember. Of course, we've got those big drop-offs as well on the edge in some areas of the stage, which mean mistakes are going to be very costly around here. Lots of hairpins as well. Really, this stage gives you no time to rest at all. It is mentally very draining.
Yeah, I was speaking to a rally driver who's preparing for this rally Monte Carlo coming up in January in the World Championship. And he was sort of saying, you know, this rally is not a rally, it's a lottery.
Whoa.
I think he saved it. I think he saved it, but up on two wheels there, that happens quite a lot with the R2s. It's so easy just to kind of overcook it. You can see these arm posts sticking out on the exit of corners. It's really important to try and remember where they are if you can, because they can really catch you out. But as you can see, these drivers absolutely drive off the door that handles with this.
Well, don't forget the top three are going to be going through to the semi-final. We're about halfway through now, and Juuna Pankkinen is fighting for the lead there. So he is doing very well. Lukas Mateja at the moment is in second place, but also running very well is Sam Thornton, the Australian driver. We also have down in fifth place Maxime Wagner as well. And we are on board with Matthias Adielsen, the Swedish driver, who is in third place at the moment. So at the moment, we'll be just going through with Juuna Pankkinen in second. And we're going to go on board now with first place, who is Lukas Mateja. So Katie, I'll hand it over to you to talk us a little bit through the stage.
Yeah, so as you can see, it's very difficult to see. The last thing they want to happen is to damage their light pods as well, especially in these conditions. That's really important. Setting them up as well is really important, but you can see the rock sticks out on the inside, and he's taking quite a central line through this stage. They're not really cutting on the inside because the rock face jolts out, there's armcos. So I think for Rally Monte Carlo especially, you can see we're starting to go up into the mountain a bit, so we're going up into that snowbank. There's loose snow on the sides, but also they've got the studded tyres on, so it's not that much of a problem. That's kind of coming into work now. The tyres will be nice and warm, but at the same time, if they've been practicing during the day, there's more ice at night, it's obviously colder, so that if there's been any kind of water during the day that's kind of defrosted, it's now frozen again, creating a really slippery layer. So it might be different conditions to what they practiced in. You know, if they're expecting day, might be a little bit more snow and a little bit more slippery than they'd anticipated.
Yeah, that is one thing that they weren't told. Now we can see into the final two sections of the stage, ice and snow only, as they now come through the right-hander into a sharp left. We are on board with Lucas Mateja, who is leading at the moment, but you can see the top right of your screen constantly changing in positions, particularly with Sam Thornton there, as well as the likes of Maxime Wagner. So it's very close. The top three are going to go through, and at the moment Sam Thornton will be one of those, and we ride on board with him at the moment. Juuna Pankkinen will be the other one, as well as Sam Thornton in third place. So very, very close. Lucas Mateja looking very good at the moment, just missing out in fourth place at the moment is Maxime Wagner.
Oh, they're switching around so much. You can see those numbers kind of going up and down on the side. You can see from the splits that we've had in, split number four, so that was a little while ago, but all within a second of each other. It's really tight racing. All splits, one, two, and three, have all been within 1 or 2 seconds with each other, so none of the drivers are hanging around out there.
It's getting very close, and we're getting towards the end now, so this is it, the final few corners to push as much as you can. If you're sitting in fourth, fifth or sixth, it's now time to give it everything. If you're in first, second or third, you cannot make a mistake, otherwise you will be eliminated. This is the first of our quarterfinals on Steam, and the top three are going to go through, six of them out there. Which three will make it now as we come up to the final few corners? We are watching Sam Thornton, who holds the last qualifying place at the moment. Just ahead is Juuna Pankkinen and Lucas Mateja in fourth place. It is Maxime Wagner, who will be desperate now as we come through the final few corners to try and gain a few seconds to get himself into the top three, and that step closer to the Autosport show in January. Just the right-hander now to go, and that is it complete. Juuna Pankkinen goes through, as well as Sam Thornton and Lucas Mateja as well. In fact, did we have some changes at the end? We'll get confirmation of the results shortly. We got on board with John Harris, who we didn't talk a huge amount about throughout that, but was sitting off the back, and there we can see the results. So it is Lucas Mateja, Juuna Pankkinen and Sam Thornton who go through.